just an overview of what it's like for a patient receiving Lutathera at our institution. I'm just going to go over what to expect the night before, the morning of, before infusion, during infusion, and after infusion and discharge. So the day before, there have been questions about, are there any dietary restrictions? The answer is no. You can eat anything that you like. We had patients who asked that, well, I usually have wine, you know, with my dinner. Is that okay? That is perfectly fine. We just, you know, advise you not to overindulge and get dehydrated, because one of the things during treatment is that you are going to get dehydrated. So that's one of the things we do advise. On the morning of, again, no restrictions. Most people will have a little bit of something so that you're not coming in with a totally empty stomach, but usually it's not a heavy meal. So you arrive around 7:30 in the morning. You check in with our receptionist, and arrival time, it is dependent on your institution, but here at Rush, we go ahead and have people come in around 7:30. Oops, sorry. The next thing is you're going to be meeting with our nursing staff. They will ask you to go ahead and change into hospital attire. And the reason for this is that during the actual treatment, you know, because the Lutathera does have a radioactive, we like to minimize the chance of it getting on your street clothes. So we go ahead and have you change into hospital attire. We patients are treated in a separate room, so we do orient you to the room, the washing facilities, and such. We go ahead and take your vitals. One of the things we do do during the course of the treatment is monitor your vitals, blood pressure, heart rate, and so forth. This is a typical room, and you notice that we do put absorbent pads throughout the room, and that is just in the event of a spill. And it's also there to make cleanup a lot easier so that the room can be released for the next patient. We also, as you notice, for the restroom facilities, there is lining on the toilet. We, regardless of whether you're male or female, you will need to be seated when you use the restroom facilities. Oops, sorry, my apologies. We have our advanced practice staff come and meet with you. They will do a very brief medical and surgical history with you and make sure that any of your medications that you normally will be taking at home is ordered for you. After that, the nursing staff will return, and they will put in an IV catheter. It's done peripherally in a vein in your arm, and all of the medications will be coming through this one area. And then before you are discharged for home, they will remove the catheter. Radiation safety will come by, and they will talk to you about the do's and the don'ts, you know, following the radiation safety procedure. They do provide this to you also in written form, so you will have this when you leave our facility. And on this letter also, it will give the amount of Lutathera that you receive for that day, so that way if you're you need to go to the airport where you'll have something in writing in case you happen to set up any of their detectors. And on the same token, even if you're in a public area, I guess law enforcement these days also have some of them actually do monitor for things like this. So it's good to carry this letter around. So the PRRT treatment, infusion itself, is in three parts. There's, as Dr. Polite had mentioned, you have your antiemetics, which are your anti-nausea medications. And it is true that the main cause of that nausea is from the amino acid solution. So at Rush, we too give two different types of amino acid. Antiemetics. We give amend and Zofran. The amend we do tend to do roughly 45 minutes to 60 minutes before the amino acid solution is done. But the Zofran we do about 15 minutes ahead of time. The amino acid solution is given second, and the two main components that are meant to afford the best kidney protection is the lysine and the arginine. So it is present in the solution, and it's there to basically protect the kidneys from the radioactivity effects. And this begins about 30 minutes before receiving the Lutathera. So here is a picture of one of our patients. You can see they are in a bed in a reclined position. Some people like to be sitting more up, so we just adjust the bed according to your preference. Nuclear medicine will come in and they will talk to you about the infusion process itself and answer any questions that you may have. We also, as part of our policy, the nuclear medicine department will have you sign a consent form agreeing to the treatment. And there's an example there. Lutathera is given third. It takes a total of about 30 minutes for it to be infused, and it is given at the same time as the amino acid solution. And typically it's given, well, it takes about 30 minutes for the infusion to occur, and during that time, our nursing staff is monitoring you for side effects and also your vitals. So here's kind of a diagram of what the tubing's connections look like. So on the right side where it says NaCl, that's normal saline. Basically, it's a salt water solution. That actually goes into the vial that contains the Lutathera medication. What it does is it flows in and it actually mixes with the Lutathera present. And then the long needle that's coming out is then goes to the patient. So it's kind of like this fluid kind of roundabout way of getting into the system. And because of the fact that you cannot see the actual medication, because of the fact that it's in a very small vial and it's inside of a container that's lined with lead, the way that it's monitored is radiation safety will use the Geiger counter during the course of the treatment to make sure that all of the Lutathera has gone into your system. So when it becomes zero or close to zero, they know that everything has gotten into you. Oops, sorry. The amino acid solution is about 2 liters. It is given in its entirety. The total time for it to be given is about 4 to 5 hours. It's closer to 4 hours, but if patients are having a lot of problems with nausea or having headache, we do reduce the time, the flow rate, and so maybe the total time for the amino acid solution will end up being about 5 hours. And during this entire time, and you're monitored and managed for any symptoms that you may have. And as I just mentioned, the solution, amino acid solution rate can be adjusted if needed. We do offer rescue medication if needed. Usually we start off with Ativan, and then if you still need something more, we go to Compazine, and then you still need more after that, we do the Zyprexa. Other symptoms are just managed as needed, so if you're having a very bad headache, then we'll go ahead and offer you Tylenol, or it could be even non-medicinal therapies, ice packs, heat pads, whatever is needed to make you feel comfortable. Okay. And then after the Lutathera is finished, and as well as the amino acid solution, we do keep you here at the hospital, usually another hour or two, just until it looks like you're able to, you feel comfortable enough to go home. As I mentioned, you will receive your a letter that it discusses like how much Lutathera you did receive, as well as you know what to do in terms of your activities once you go home. We also remove your catheter. We provide you with your scripts for any additional nausea medications that you may need. And then the average time from arrival to a facility to discharge is about 7 to 8 hours. So just so you know, in terms of planning ahead. And that is it. So hopefully I've eased your mind a little bit.